Hiking in paradise. Our goal was to escape the city and be unwired from the internet for 2 days, and to do some short hikes along the way. We chose to spend 2 nights at the Paradise Lodge on the Rogue River in Oregon. The only access to the lodge is by foot on the Rogue River Trail or by water in a raft or jet boat. Carol has twice hiked the Rogue River Trail. Me, I'm more lazy, so we chose the jet boat option from Gold Beach. Day one was the 160-mile drive to get to Gold Beach. We drove south from Eugene to Drain. In Drain, we observed a 1902 Queen Anne house being remodeled as a future bed and breakfast. We drove Highway 38 to the coast with the mandatory stop at the Dean Creek Elk Viewing Area, where the elk were being cooperative and resting near the road. From there, we drove down the coast and arrived in Gold Beach in the late afternoon. We checked into our quaint 1950s motel run by an older couple and picked up our jet boat tickets at Jerry's. We walked around a bit to see the sights of Gold Beach and had dinner at the Barnacle Bistro Cafe. Day 2, the 54-mile jet boat trip upriver to Paradise. We had to arrive at the dock at 7:30 a.m. to check in, and the boat launched at 8 a.m. The morning temperature is typically cool and overcast along the coast and becomes warmer as you head inland. The trip to Agnes is below the wild section. In this section of the trip, we saw otter, eagles, osprey, heron, and of course, the rogue bears. Once we passed Agnes and the takeout for the wild and scenic raft trips, Foster Bar, then we began seeing rafts and kayaks and some rapids. In this section, housing is limited to those grandfathered in before the wild designation. The favorite activity, and to some such as me, the most annoying part of the ride, was the 360-degree jet boat spins. They just do not seem appropriate for a river as wild, scenic, and beautiful as the Rogue. Clay Hill Rapid is the final challenging rapid for those coming down the river. Paradise Lodge is just a few miles upriver and our destination. Exploring the Rogue River Trail near Paradise Lodge. We arrived around noon to begin our stay in Paradise, and we would be leaving around noon after our one full day stay. We had 2 half days, the first afternoon and the last morning, to do short hikes, and 1 full day to explore the upriver trail to Marial Lodge. Going downriver is all in the shade. Going upriver is mostly exposed to the hot sun. Unfortunately, we did the upriver section. It was 100 degrees in the shade and 116 degrees while sitting on the rocks and observing the rafts exiting Blossom Bar Rapid. Marial Lodge hike was about 4.5 miles one way and covers the entire Mule Creek Canyon section of the river. On the way, we observed Stair Creek Falls. I have done the wild and scenic section of the Rogue 7 times in a hardshell kayak. I was reliving those good times. There are 3 tough sections in the canyon. The jaws at the entrance, where the water rises into a boil. You can either navigate the boil or take the sneak path on the river right. The coffee pot, with its infamous swirling water, has eaten many a boater, me included. And finally, the exit at Blossom Bar Rapid. Blossom Bar is fun for a kayak because we are so maneuverable and can play in it. But at the same time, rafts, which are slower and heavier, have a much more difficult time. This year, the water is low, so that 3 rafts already this week were pinned on the rocks at the exit. Thank you. Finally, it was time to head back to civilization and get connected and check our email and answer our voicemails.